because I think that in living in the States, you're living in one of the most brutal societies in the history of the world. You know, the country who inherited the genocide of the Native American peoples, a country which participated in chattel slavery. The only country in the world to use and drop an atomic bomb on another country, society. The country which murdered and enslaved millions in Southeast Asia as a result of the Vietnam War. And we drew from the people who resisted. We were inspired because we feel that any society or any government or any system that is set up solely to profit a wealthy class, while the majority of the people toil and suffer and sell their labor power, so long as that system's only true motive is profit interest and not the maintenance and betterment of the population to meeting human needs, then that society should not stand. It should be challenged and questioned and overthrown. And waking up to the long legacy of brutality of American history and subjugating the world's population has been something we wanted to challenge through music. Initially, I was drawn to music really, really early in my life. I don't know whether I had friends who were older than me who turned me on to different things. I think initially I was listening to, like, Hendrix. I was listening to a little bit of jazz. I was listening to Charlie Parker at a very young age, and I was just drawn to it. I started playing guitar at first. It was my first instrument I played. Later, I think it was just an instinctual thing. You know, there was a... I grew up in a very, I was a Mexicano in a part of the country where I was the exception to the rule, because most Mexicanos in Orange County were there because they had a broom or a hammer in their hands or picking baskets of strawberries, you know. So this is, I had a deep sense of frustration, alienation I experienced growing up in a very conservative community, very racist, very conservative community. And I think that's what initially attracted me to punk music and punk culture. Yeah. Well, I mean, there were so many, I think, the people that I were listening to at the time, you know, really moved me. People like Iggy Pop, The Stooges, the MC5, Public Enemy. We felt that those were two mediums which, you know, instinctually moved us, you know, and we felt could provide the most compelling backdrop for our ideas, you know. I grew up breakdancing, I grew up playing punk rock music, you know, I grew up listening to it, you know. It spoke to me in a way that no other music until that point could speak to me. So I, it kind of happened. It was spontaneous. It wasn't a lot of thought put into it, you know. Yeah, we were very excited about the idea of playing hip-hop with live instrumentation, you know, and fusing the music that we loved so much, that we felt drawn to. So I don't know, it was very spontaneous. There's no way to say exactly how the sounds came together or why.